This is lesson 3-2a, how to simplify radicals. There's three basic rules for simplification that most authors agree upon. They are as follows. No perfect nth factors inside the radical, no fractions inside the radical, and no radicals in the denominator. So here we have example one. Simplify the fifth root of 3/4. We don't like that fraction inside, so one thing we can do is we can separate the numerator and denominator. So step one will be to write up the fifth root of 3 over the fifth root of 4. That took care of the fraction inside the radical, but now I've got a radical in the denominator, which I don't like. Now there's two ways of going about this. One way would be to say, I've got one factor of 4, I could use 4 more for a total of 5, but that wouldn't be the best route. You should note that 4 can be written as 2 times 2. So let me do that. I'll say the fifth root of 3 over the fifth root of 2 times 2. Now it's going to be easier to simplify. I've got 2 factors of 2, I need 3 more to bring it to a total of 5. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to multiply the bottom by 3 factors of 2 inside the radical with the fifth index. And I'm going to do it to the top also. So I'll use red so you can see what I'm doing. So I'll go times 2 times 2 times 2. And what I do to the bottom, I can do the top times 2 times 2 times 2. As long as I've got that same index, I can do that inside. All right, so now I've got 5 factors, so one of them comes out. And over here I've got 2 times 2 times 2, 8 times 3, that's just 24. So that'll be the fifth root of 24 all over 2. And keep in mind, if I had like a 4 there, you know, I'd want to simplify the integers. So that's my answer, and that's how to simplify radicals.